The WWC reports on findings from within studies that meet the eligibility requirements specified in the review protocol and that meet WWC design standards with or without reservations. Often studies will report multiple findings, sometimes for the same outcome measure on different samples, or for multiple outcomes within a single outcome domain. The WWC has procedures for reporting on findings in these studies. Additionally, the WWC summarizes the design, features, and samples of each study to provide important context for the findings. In most products, the WWC reports on all eligible findings that meet WWC design standards with or without reservations. Studies sometimes include multiple analyses of the same outcome measure. For example, the outcome may have been measured at different points in time for different samples or using different measurement approaches. In these cases, the WWC needs to determine which findings will contribute to its summary of the evidence in the study or intervention. Among those eligible findings that meet WWC design standards, the WWC designates one or more findings reported in the study as the main findings that contribute to the WWC summary of the evidence. Findings that do not contribute to this main summary are considered supplemental and may be reported separately, such as in an appendix. The WWC follows a set of guidelines when distinguishing main and supplemental findings. When a study measures the effectiveness of an intervention at multiple points in time, such as immediately after the intervention concludes and again later, the WWC chooses one point in time to focus on as the main finding. For example, a review protocol in a topic area where effects can take time to observe might specify that the latest follow-up is preferred. The WWC applies a more general rule to studies that report both a full sample finding and findings for one or more subgroups within the full sample. Subgroups might be defined by location, cohort, or student characteristics like gender or race and ethnicity. In this case, the WWC considers the full sample finding to be the main finding. The subgroup findings are reported in supplemental tables. If the study does not report a full sample finding, but two or more subgroup findings meet WWC design standards, the WWC will aggregate the findings into a single finding for the outcome measure using a weighted average. The formula for the weighted average is provided in the Procedures Handbook. When a study reports both the effect of the intervention on a composite score and on one or more subscale scores used to calculate the composite score, the WWC considers the finding based on the composite score to be the main finding, and the subscale findings are reported in supplemental tables. Remember, the WWC always determines the main findings in a study from among those that are eligible according to the criteria in the review protocol and meet WWC design standards. For example, if the full sample finding in a study does not meet WWC design standards, but a subgroup finding does, then the subgroup finding is the main finding in the study and contributes to the WWC's summary of the evidence. These rules allow the WWC to characterize a study's findings based on the most comprehensive information available. However, not all studies will report a single finding or set of findings that reflects the full sample for the composite outcome measure and performed time period. When applying these rules is not straightforward because of incomplete information about findings, overlapping samples, or other complications, the review team leadership has discretion for a study or group of studies under review to identify main and supplemental findings in a way that best balances the goals of comprehensively characterizing each study's findings and presenting the findings in a clear and straightforward manner. Some WWC review efforts are designated as expedited by IES. For expedited reviews, the review team leadership also has discretion to focus each study review on eligible findings only from the full sample rather than on subgroups, only using composite measures rather than subscales, only using the most relevant time period as specified in the applicable review protocol, and only using the most relevant comparison group. Other eligible findings within a study may not be reviewed when the WWC conducts an expedited review. When using WWC design standards to review a study, The WWC gives each eligible finding in the study a rating and assigns a rating for the full study. Different contrasts within the same study may receive different ratings, such as when a full sample finding meets WWC group design standards without reservations, but a subgroup finding in the same study has high attrition and meets WWC group design standards with reservations. The study receives the highest rating among all the ratings given to eligible findings. So, for example, if any finding in a study, whether main or supplementary, meets WWC group design standards without reservations, the study as a whole will also receive that rating, even if a finding in the study is rated meets WWC group design standards with reservations or does not meet WWC group design standards. Within each outcome domain, the WWC characterizes main study findings across outcome measures. The WWC assigns one of five possible characterization labels to a domain based on the direction, magnitude, and statistical significance of the findings. These labels are statistically significant positive effects, substantively important positive effects, indeterminate effects, substantively important negative effects, statistically significant negative effects. The WWC defines a substantively important effect size as one that is 0.25 standard deviations or larger. The criteria for the characterization of findings depend on whether the domain includes main findings from one or more outcome measures. If there is a single outcome measure in the domain, then the main finding for that outcome measure determines the characterization. If there are main findings from multiple outcome measures in a domain, the WWC will base its characterization on one or more of the following three sets of information about the findings: the individual effect sizes and the number of findings that are individually statistically significant, the simple average of the effect sizes and a WWC calculated measure of their statistical significance as a group, or a study-reported omnibus test, which is a single test that combines the outcome measures. Now let's look more closely at the criteria for each of these study-level characterizations of findings. There are two possible designations that indicate favorable effects of an intervention. When an outcome domain includes a main finding from only one outcome measure, the WWC designates the finding as a statistically significant positive effect if the effect size is positive and statistically significant. The WWC designates the finding as a substantively important positive effect if the effect size is positive and not statistically significant, but is large enough to be considered substantively important. When an outcome domain includes findings from multiple outcome measures, the outcome domain receives a characterization of statistically significant positive effects if it meets one or more of three criteria. The first way is based on the individual effect sizes and the number of findings that are individually statistically significant. At least one finding must be positive and statistically significant, and none can be negative and statistically significant. The measure of statistical significance must include any adjustments required by the WWC, discussed later in this module. The second way is based on the WWC calculated average effect size and statistical significance of the average. These calculations must result in a positive and statistically significant average effect size. The individual findings have no direct role in the characterization based on this second criterion. The third way is based on the findings from a study-reported omnibus test, if provided. Again, the finding must be statistically significant and positive. Whether an outcome domain with multiple outcomes can receive a characterization of substantively important positive effects is based only on the WWC calculated average effect size. To receive this characterization, the average effect size must be positive, not statistically significant, and 0.25 standard deviations or larger. It is possible for the domain to meet the criteria for both a statistically significant and substantively important positive effect. In this case, the domain receives the characterization of statistically significant positive effect. The WWC will apply the same criteria to an outcome domain used to identify a statistically significant positive effect or substantively important positive effect to identify those having a statistically significant negative effect or substantively important negative effect, except that positive effect sizes are replaced by negative effect sizes. Again, if the outcome domain meets criteria for both, the WWC will characterize it as a statistically significant negative effect. The WWC uses criteria similar to those for positive effects when characterizing negative effects for domain-level findings based on a single outcome measure or multiple outcome measures. When the main findings in a study outcome domain do not meet the criteria for either positive effects or negative effects, the WWC will characterize the findings as indeterminate. Returning to the Reading Recovery Intervention Report, the findings in the alphabetics domain for Schwartz 2005 were characterized as statistically significant positive effects. The average effect size was 0.62 standard deviations, which is positive, and the WWC determined that this average effect size is statistically significant. The WWC also documents information about a study that will not affect that study's rating. The WWC documents the study setting, characteristics of the study sample, features of the intervention and comparison groups, including any implementation issues, and how the intervention and comparison groups were formed. In addition, the WWC documents certain common issues that can affect how to interpret a study finding, including non-participation, contamination, and lack of fidelity. Non-participation occurs when sample members assigned to the intervention group do not participate in the intervention. If not all sample members participated in the intervention, but these non-participants are still analyzed as part of the intervention group, the effectiveness finding may be smaller than the finding that might have been obtained had all intervention group members participated. Contamination occurs when sample members assigned to the comparison condition receive the intervention. This is sometimes referred to as crossover. If these sample members provide outcome data and are analyzed as comparison group members, contamination can lead to a smaller finding. Finally, lack of fidelity occurs when components of the intervention are not implemented. Variations in implementation are to be expected in studies of interventions because they take place in real-life settings and not necessarily under tightly controlled conditions monitored by researchers. If effective intervention components are omitted, findings might be smaller. If a study includes information related to any of these topics, reviewers document this information during the review, and it may be included as context when describing the study and its findings in a WWC product. The WWC documents this information, but it does not affect how the study is rated. However, if a key component of an intervention was not implemented, the study cannot be considered to provide a true test of the intervention of interest, and it may be ineligible for review.